And here we go, guys. Down at the bottom of the map, we have our Zerg player, the winner of the last game from the team Startail. Played very, very well. He is.
Startail Curious.
He's got some fans in the audience today. He's gaining some popularity. And up at the top of the map, speaking of a popular guy, from Team Dignitas, he is...
Dignitas Sjow.
You know, it's kind of cool. It's actually really cool to see Sjow here in Korea. I mean, going back to, going back 5 or 6 months here, like later last year when I was casting a lot of those online events and seeing him play, it's kind of cool to be here casting this and have him here playing. It's kind of neat. I don't know. I'm just feeling all nostalgic right now, Moltrap.
No, it's very cool. I'm sorry, I don't have the same nostalgia. I never casted any Sjow games before he came to Korea that I can remember.
That's okay.
I've definitely heard of him a lot, though. He's been in tons of tournaments.
And so, pretty normal opening from Sjow. Nothing at all wrong with doing the same opening he did last time. I mean, Reactor to Hellion, it's so good, so safe. Hatch first for Curious.
Yeah, hatch on 14. And he's probably going to pool on 14 as well, I'd imagine. Or 15, maybe 15.
Maybe 18, maybe 25 supply if he forgets for a really, really long time. Who knows?
The SCV is very low in health. Is he going to get it?
Why can't people just let SCVs build their buildings? Why? Is it so wrong? They're just trying to build a building. Come on.
Well.
Honestly.
It's war, Doa. War is brutal.
I guess all's fair in love and war, and while there may be a little bit of love, it's mostly war.
He's building a building, but, you know, it's like saying, why hurt the building? It's just a building. Well, it's building a tank, Doa, and that tank's going to blow up your buildings.
That's different. It's a preventative strike, I guess. We'll call
it that way.
So, looks like a gas steal. Now, if he is going Reactor Hellion open, he doesn't need the second gas too soon, so... That is okay. Oh, the drone doesn't actually get back on the extractor fast enough. Whoops.
Well, he may have actually wanted to do that to try and scout this front with it before it died.
He does see it.
He does see the factory and the reactor.
Yeah. And there's a Roach Warren. Good response by Curious there. If you keep in mind what we saw our last game, our last CVT, we saw Gumiho do the same opening, you know, and then go into Marine Tank. So a little bit different than what Sjow would normally do, but... There was no Roach response by the Zerg player, by Monster, and Curious is building the Roaches. He wants that map control. He doesn't want to give that up to Hellions early on. Yeah. I mean, he was around, too. He saw that other game here earlier today, so wants to play safe.
And it's a really smart move. I mean, you don't have to make that many Roaches. You can defend a Reactor Hellion opening with 3 Roaches.
Yeah, you only
need,
like,
3. And if you make, like, 5 or 6, you're basically immune to any number of Hellions that they're going to make for
a
while.
He's making just 4 Roaches right now.
4 Roaches. So that's going to give him the ability to have, if he wants to, he can even leave 2 at home to defend and send out 3 to, you know, clear out towers and make sure that he's not sneaking a gold base or anything silly like that.
And if he does catch the Hellions, he can also put a little bit of pressure on the opponent too if Sjow doesn't have a bunker or anything like that. It's actually pretty easy to kill those couple Marines that are there with an opening
exactly.
here.
Exactly.
That may be exactly what he's planning, actually. He might not even really be worrying about the Hellions, but he's going to catch him coming down. Oh, no. That is a disaster for Sjow. That Hellion is at such low health that drones can handle it now. And now, for sure, Sjow is going to be under some pressure from these Roaches.
Yeah, there are 5 Roaches. Oh. He's going to keep his next few Roaches at home to defend against Hellions.
Good idea.
And 5 Roaches running to the front.
Yeah.
And they could do some damage. There's only a couple Marines. He's building a bunker.
Yeah, he did.
The bunker is almost complete, but it's not quite going to complete in time.
Oh, who's going to get this SCV building the bunker? The Hellions can basically fire all day. It's not a lot of damage. Looks like the bunker will complete, so Sjow should be just fine here. Yeah, he'll be fine.
Yeah,
yep. Close call.
Loses 1 Roach and gets 3 SCVs for it. Not a bad deal.
Yep. Yeah, if Sjow hadn't built that bunker, he'd be in huge trouble right now.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
But he knows. He's a professional. Knows what to do. So, again, a pretty quick stim again. So, it looks like we're probably going to move into a fairly similar mid-game to what we saw last time from Sjow. Whereas Curious is going to be playing a little bit differently. May decide, though. Yeah, he's getting Zergling speed now, so he may decide just to leave it at that for the Roaches and then just go into Mutaling again.
Yes, probably That would be the wise thing to do.
Yeah.
He's not going to keep making Hellions at this point, so very smart move to just say, all right, well, that's enough Roaches. I need to drone up now.
Yeah, well, Mutas are actually pretty strong on this map. I mean, they're not bound by the thin running lanes that the other ground units are. You know, they can get away that much easier from Marines that might be chasing him, so Mutas would be a good choice on this map for sure.
Yeah. Definitely be a strong choice. He's not actually mining gas right now. Curious, that is. But he just got enough gas for... basically, hold that thought. Roaches have gathered up together, and they're trying to push in here and
punish
Sjow for taking his expansion. And he doesn't quite have enough Marines and Marauders out yet to deal with this.
Well, there are a couple Marauders plus a Bunker. I think he's going to be just fine. Yeah, he does push those Roaches away. And I was a little bit worried about that Nashville for a moment, but Sjow's well prepared. Run, Marauder! He's like, don't leave me hanging. He wasn't left hanging. Good news, guys.
No, he only had 20 hit points left.
Oh, look at that.
Was not left hanging with it.
So smart by Curious to send that Overlord in while he was distracting Sjow at the front.
Nice.
Yeah, just what I was saying about Curious. I feel like he gets a little bit better each time we see him play.
Okay, he's playing very smart, and he has been droning up like crazy. Getting his lair now. Finally getting his lair. That's actually kind of a late lair. But,
Yep. Well, when you get the Roaches and things like that early on, it does always slow things down.
Yeah, yeah.
A little bit more pressure against Sjow, but he's going to be able to hold this easily again. And, maybe Curious getting a little bit too aggressive there. I mean, it's not a big deal. He's not going to really need those units later, like late in the game, but...
No, but it would have been handy to keep those around to deal with... Well, that was kind of weird. We saw it canceled.
I think he actually accidentally made a tech lab there.
Okay. Yeah. It would have been handy to have those Roaches sitting around to block Hellions running by in his drone line later on, that kind of thing. Mm-hmm. So he kind of wasted them, but he is still in okay shape, putting a macro hatch down in his natural instead of going for a third.
Yep. And looks like the Viking for Sjow, if it decides to, should be able to get in and see everything. So both players should be pretty well aware of what each other are doing, is doing.
The lair is completed, and he's not really using it just yet. He's getting Baneling speed with the lair, but...
Oh, these guys getting caught a little bit out of position. They'll get taken down by these Zerglings. And Sjow's doing a little bit of a kind of a Marine Marauder Hellion push here. Oh, no, if he loses his first tank, that'd be unfortunate. Nope, he'll be just fine. Enough Marines there.
And, yeah, big drop going in on the back of Curious's base. Curious does not... have any Overlord coverage on the map right now, so he is not going to see this coming in time, and they're going to be able to get a drop down in the back.
Oh, somebody's going in. Ready though.
But he's got a nice position behind those minerals.
Yeah, enough Marines in there to handle the Zerglings, do some DPS as well. The Marauders firing at the same time, but looks like Curious has just enough Zerglings to handle it. Two Marauders escaping. They too were not left hanging.
Nope, but the Spire's almost complete, so he's going to have only a short window of time where he can make use of these drops.
Well, this Roach stuff by Curious, I mean, he may have actually taken a little bit too far. He made enough Roaches that it delayed his lair and his Spire quite a bit longer. That may not end up mattering, but it's something to kind of consider here in the middle of the map. Link's trying to do some damage. I don't know if this is enough, but they'll at least be able to take out the tank. Looks like it is. Silly me. And wow.
Yeah, this is actually big. Again, as with last game, kind of moving out without quite enough forces to defend what he was moving out with, and loses his first couple tanks.
Yep, losing all those
and
Marines,
a lot of Marines
right before the 10 Mutas come out. That's that's never something you want happening.
That's huge.
Yep.
And Curious decides, all right, well, now I'm going to take a third in the bottom left.
Yep.
Bottom right, rather.
Now, these guys are staying pretty even in supply for the moment anyway, but once that third picks up, Curious, that will change. Worker count to actually fairly even as well. Curious isn't as big as droning up on some of the other Zerg players we've seen lately. He likes to have a lot of offensive units out on the field too, and that may also be something that Sjow is not quite used to handling quite as often. It's fairly uncommon. Oh, the drop's going to be spotted though. And here come the Mutas to make everything all better for Zerg.
Yep. I like how the Viking lands to kill some drones, though. He gets three drones, I think, with that Viking before it dies, so
yeah,
not
nice
too
little
bad.
Move. Might as well do that. You know, you're not going to escape otherwise.
Yeah, Viking's not that good against Mutas.
Yeah. Looks like Joe's going to try to take the gold base to get back into this game.
Oh, that is interesting.
Yeah, well, I mean, he needs to do something like this. He's pretty far behind right now. And the mutas are going to get in there right as the turrets finish. They're just going to bypass him, possibly.
There's a lot of Marines there, though.
Yeah, he's losing a lot of reinforcing Marines. And he's going to lose another tank, too, possibly.
No. Yep. And it looks like Sjow... Yeah, he's going to be able to defend that. Mm. He has all of his army on one hotkey, so you saw his tanks were actually getting in the way of his Marines going up that ramp.
Yeah. And those medevacs, no.
Oh, same with the medevacs.
Totally out of position with the medevacs. I hate to say it, but I feel like Curious is just really obviously outplaying Sjow right now. I mean, Sjow just seems to be having a really hard time keeping up with everything.
He's kind of dancing around him with these mutalists.
Yeah.
And, oh no, Sjow, another medevac just kind of caught out of position.
Yep, and this is why mutas are so good on this map.
He has no medevacs on the map, I don't think.
Yeah.
But he's got two more that just came out.
Yeah. He's going to try to keep the gold safe. It is going to be tough for the mutas to really cause any trouble at the gold right now. There's not enough to really take down turrets efficiently at the moment. Oh, he's going into the main. He's going to try to snipe a tank, but the Marines are chasing away. Look at that Marine micro.
The Zerglings coming in as well. Are going to really clean that up. Links.
Should be fine. And, Sjow's falling farther and farther behind. He does have the gold, but looks like he's going to lose his army again. Magic box on the Thor. And that's enough links by themselves to take care of that. And I think we may actually see a GG from Sjow fairly soon. He does have the gold, but just losing a lot of his army units here.
Ow. Just at the last second, those last few Zerglings took out so many SCVs, though.
Yeah.
Down to only 48.
Oh, the mutas are pretty low. Well, I guess we will be able to kill the mutas. What is Curious doing?
Well,
that was a curious move.
That was a curious move indeed. Hopefully for him, I guess, at this point in the game, this is when Maka made like 10 command centers for no reason and lost. So, I mean, Curious might be feeling a little bit overconfident here, and maybe
that's why he kind of threw
away his mutas
and
his Zerglings, but he still has the advantage.
Well, you know, it was right on the edge of where you thought things, you know, might end. You know, you heard me say we might see a GG soon, because it was kind of on the edge. Curious kind of thought that as well. Looks like both he and I were wrong, however.
I think that gold base is in danger, Doa. Zerglings and Banelings from both sides, and that is... almost enough to pop the planetary. He's going to go for it, and SCVs can't quite get enough surface area to repair. Oh, my gosh.
Serious?
Oh.
Okay, there we go. Did cancel his extractor. I didn't see that. Yeah.
Yes, he canceled the refinery. A small victory for Sjow.
27 minerals. All right.
But here's the thing. Curious has countered with the gold base on the other side of the map.
Yep.
And... so Sjow is going to be way behind economically. He's mined out in his main. He's only mining from his natural right now. It is 1,700 minerals a minute to 700 for Sjow.
Yeah, it's still, I mean, that engagement at the gold was also pretty sloppy, too. So Curious is definitely giving him an opportunity here. Taking down some turrets again. Not enough Marines to handle those.
And Sjow is not turning around.
Nope, he's just got to go for it now.
He knows that it's all in or nothing right now. Here he's going out, but there's Zerglings and Banelings coming in. The Thor trying to target down the Banelings, but doesn't quite kill them fast enough, and everything goes down. And 3, 2, 1.
I don't know, man.
Nope.
You might try to save a little bit longer.
Yeah. Sorry.
Yeah, well...
I've been pretty good.
There we go.
There
it is, yeah. So...
a few seconds off.
That's a rough one for Sjow. But Curious played really well. I mean, he did just straight up outplay Sjow in those games. Showed us that he deserves to be in the up and downs.
Yeah.
And, you know, again, you know, don't get too down, all you foreign fans out there. Sjow is here to train. You know, he's in Code A. He's going to be in Code A again next season if he chooses to be.
Yeah, we're actually going to see... a lot of foreigners in Code A next season because and Sjow are still going to be there next season because they advanced to the round of 16 this season, and then we're going to have some probable seeds from MLG as well next season. So,
well, I feel like overall we're starting to see foreigners put on a better performance for us in the GSL. So I think despite, you know, we've lost all our foreigners in the round of 16 here, I think overall things are generally... slowly improving for foreigners here in Korea.
Definitely.
You know, I mean, with more and more people coming out here to train, you know, Major slash Terran slash whatever his idea now is training at TSL. So he's also a very talented Terran player, so we could definitely see him in the GSL as well.
Yeah.
At some point, I'm sure he's going to be trying to qualify. So, yeah, we'll see.
We will see indeed.
Yep.
And very exciting just in general to have that cross-pollination going on. To have, I mean, partners like MVP partnering with Complexity, like that's just kind of cool in general that they're partnering like that. Of course, OGS and TL have been partnered for a while now.
Yeah, they were kind of the first teams to really make something like that work. Let's take a look at our match results for today, the first day of the round of 16. We had MVP SC coming out on top in his match against Dignitas Select. Slayer's Yu-Gi-Oh! Breaking his curse and taking down Liquid Hero in a pretty crazy exciting conclusion to that match. FXO Gumiho coming out on top with MVP Monster. And StarTail Curious taking down Dignitas Sjow. So we have got Zergs to Terrans all over the place, man. We've got a ZVT in both of our round of eight matches on that side of the brackets.
Yep, and of course on the other side of the bracket, tomorrow we're going to have the next half of the round of 16. And that is going to be JYP versus Fruit Dealer and Dream versus Lucky, a PVZ and a TVZ. And then Oz versus Superstar and Check versus Sage. So another PVZ, another ZVP. I guess it'll be the same thing. So three PVZs and a ZVT at Zerg Day tomorrow at Code A round 16.
That's right. Still three Protoss alive in the tournament. Don't you guys worry. And these, you know, I really feel like these are the best Protoss we have. Well, no, take that back. Kira's really good too.
Well,
never mind, they're
I'm
all
really curious to see what Sage can pull out because he's kind of this guy that we haven't seen very much of yet.
He played really well.
But he's kind of being really hyped up right now.
Yeah.
So tomorrow we're going to probably learn a little bit more about if the hype is warranted or not. So.
Oh, yeah, come back later tonight. We're going to be here for this. It's going to be the first of our GSL Team League playoff matches. We're going to have Prime versus StarTail. That's going to be cool. It's kind of like weird to see Prime in the playoffs, man.
Yeah.
How they make it.
Exactly.
Yeah, the team that never won a match before in the team league makes it to the playoffs of our first long-form GSTL. So very cool to see them there. They're going to be duking it out against StarTail.
Yep.
Thanks to our sponsors again, Sony Ericsson, Intel, and G-Skill. We're going to take a break. I think it's time for us to go get some food, man. We got to recharge before the cast tonight.
We're going to be back in a couple hours, actually two... 2 hours and 10 seconds from now.
Wow, that's exact.
The GSTL will start, so we'll see you then. Have a good one. Take care.